top six teams from this qualifier are going to move on to the pro division and compete in weekly cups, while the other teams that don't qualify are going to be entered into weekly amateur cups with an opportunity to move to the pro cycle after this first season. The first game that we got today is we are going into the game with Bunny versus TFPX. All right, so we're going into the hero drafting stage right now. And the first bands that we have, the blind bands, are going to be Moon Queen, Ophelia, Parasite, and Dark Lady. And then we got the first pick, Prisoner, from the Legion. So, Minots, is Prisoner still first pick worthy?
I'm not sure about that. I haven't really followed the scene since I got back in Thailand, but I'm pretty sure it's not first pickable.
Okay. And then right away on the other side, we got Empath and Martyr picked up. So a double support. Martyr we don't see very often. Where do you see that hero fall into place, especially since we already have the Empath who will most likely be with the hard carry? Is there a chance that we're going to see the infamous Martyr suicide, or is it going to be a tri-lane?
It's probably going to be a tri-lane. They might try to do the thing that Sync Esports says is overpowered, where Martyr dies and has a carry form something with the buff that gives him experience anyway.
And then Hellbringer.
Looks like they're going for some kind of really tanky lineup. I don't know.
Yeah. All right, and then we have Rhapsody and Tempest picked up on Bunny. So it looks like we got Bunny going with the kind of traditional lineup. We're going to have a Tempest. Rhapsody has been picked up a lot lately. Wow, we're going to see something different from the Hellborn team over here.
Yeah, Hellborn's lineup is really interesting. I'm not really sure what they're going to try to do with that. Well, Legion's draft is way
pretty
more
strong.
Standard.
Yeah, pretty standard, very strong. All right, we got the Sandwraith banned. So Legion's most likely going to try to start banning a lot of the hard carries, seeing how the Hellborn team has already picked up their supports. So maybe we can see a Hellbringer mid with a Empath Martyr tri-lane with then some sort of suicide?
It's possible, I guess.
I mean, we really have no idea what's going on.
If I was on the Hellborn side of this game, I would love to play something like Legionnaire Solstice, since both Parasite and Ophelia were blind then, and you're on the Hellborn side.
But then, so that would leave you as a Martyr and Hellbringer as solos?
That's probably not optimal.
Yeah.
It's been quite some time since I saw a Martyr lane solo. And even as a support, I haven't really seen him around that much.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard for me to like judge his power level, but we'll see.
Yeah, hopefully it's pretty good. So yeah, just so you guys know, I am not a main caster. I've casted before. I've kind of been the co-caster, competitive insight, but I've never been the main caster. So I am just straight up apologizing to you guys right now if this isn't the best cast that you've ever had in your entire life. It's most likely not. So let's just get that out of the way right here. Once again, Breaky and Beef are on vacation. I just wanted to make sure that these games were casted, that we did have some content for you guys on Honcast. So I came in. We don't have a producer, so it's just going to be me and Minots kind of bringing you guys content all weekend, and hopefully you guys enjoy it. All right, so the bands are shaping up. We got Sandwraith, Kraken, Madman, Kronos, Dampier, and Lodestone are the first ones that those guys have been banned.
It's kind of interesting that Kronos went so far through the picking phase.
Yeah.
I'm assuming these guys are kind of like pub players, and Kronos is really popular in public games. Have they nerfed him at all, by the way?
Kronos has not been nerfed yet, no.
Okay. And they haven't fixed his backtrack either?
Correct. Alright, so looking at the MMRs of these guys, so Blue on the Legion team is a solid 1860 player, while it seems like the rest fall in around the 1600s, 1700s. And then on Hellborn, it looks like they're all about 1700, 1790. So high 1700s, around 1600s. So it should be a pretty even matchup. It's just, I'm really curious to see what kind of strategy these guys on Hellborn are going to be bringing out.
Yeah, might even be like a Roche level 1 with some
maybe
like weird strategy or something. Yeah, I don't know. Can you do something with Marker? Tank with Hellbringer, Lifeoid? I don't know.
Yeah, possibly. All right, so we got Malakin picked up. So Malakin's going to be the hard carry over here for the Legion lineup. And then this is the pick that I'm very interested in seeing. Who are we going to? Bramble, baby. Are we seeing a push lineup?
This is so weird.
Bramble's pretty strong, though.
Yeah, he is.
So this could.
They don't really have anything that synergizes with him.
I'm thinking that we're going to see an Empath, Martyr, Bramble tri-lane.
And Empath is really weak in their lineup. I mean, I guess you could ride around in Bramble, but like, you'd want something more like hard carry-ish for Empath. Yeah.
So Legion side finishes up with Bubbles, so we're seeing a standard competitive player lineup. And then Wretched Hag over here on the Hellborn team. So
at level 6 in the early mid game, the Hellborn team has insanely strong team fighting. So that's probably the timing they're going to aim for.
Yeah, what kind of lanes do you think we're in? Do you think we're going to see that tri lane, or do you think we're going to see Suicide?
Well, they kind of have to tri lane now.
Yeah.
I mean, they tri lane short lane or long lane, but
let's get it on.
They're probably going to man up.
Yeah?
But then again, Legion has a prisoner, and that's not really their fun here to man up against.
Well, won't the short lane be Malakin and Rhapsody? Or do you think Malakin and Rhapsody are going to go mid?
Yeah, but like if Legion anticipates them going long lane, they can just send prisoner Rhapsody both and have Malakin solo mid.
Yeah.
It all depends on what happens at level 1.
And it wouldn't be a game without a pause.
And Hellborn did not buy Kongor items. I'm disappointed.
No, they did not buy Kongor items. Hag is not getting any boosted regen, so she's likely not going to suicide.
Well, I mean, if you're putting a Hag in a 1v1, you'd want to pull a regen no matter what, but
yeah,
she still has 100 gold. She might even buy more Tangos herself.
Very true.
Lightstones, of course.
All right, I'm gonna.
But if they're not pulling Hag in a regen, I'd assume they're going to man up, because then they want as much regen as possible on their supports.
Yeah. All right. One second, I'm just adding something really quick. So, I guess one thing that people are going to want to know, do you have any plans of playing competitive Heroes of New Earth anymore?
No, I don't.
What if there's a really cool Hantura Season 3?
Yeah, maybe, but that's not what would bring me back. Like, what would bring me back would be an offer from a team to join them.
Yeah.
Like, I don't have the time or energy to put a new team together. Yeah.
Yeah.
Or that many.
You haven't. I forgot. You haven't been the captain in quite a long time.
TDM was the last time, I guess.
Yeah.
Was that next summer. Last Dreamhack summer, I suppose.
All right. Got so my fancy overlay. There we go. Fancy overlay is done.
And you're gonna need a. All a good team to compete with the new Lions roster.
Yeah, so let's talk about that. Okay, so Super KG is obviously no longer on the team. He's actually playing for Team Excellent this tournament. And then we got Limp playing on BMG. So you obviously think that that's a huge upgrade for BMG.
Well, BMG got rid of someone who they considered a weak link. I'm not going to go into what I think, but and right. Then they replaced him with Limp, who I consider the best player at home, so.
Yeah. So, I mean, and that's not just you. I mean, when we were in Thailand, I remember we were all hanging out, and it was a pretty unanimous decision from every single person out there. It was there that Limp is currently the best player in Han. So yeah. You can't get a better pickup than that.
Exactly. And BMG were already a good team. I mean, they have really talented players, and they had great synergy and teamwork. And then they picked up Limp, so they're going to be really hard to compete with.
Yeah. It'll be very interesting to see how that plays out, how Sync Esports stacks up against them. Insania's got a new team.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
They're in this tournament.
Is it like Haxorn, maybe?
Yeah.
And
I think they're all playing on different names, though.
Okay, wait. Let me guess. Who did Insania play with?
I actually don't know the full roster. I haven't looked into
really?
It. But I know that they're all playing.
Is Probus gonna team? Wait, I don't think he'll team with Probus.
I don't think so. I do not think so. Alright, the game is getting back started here.
It's about damn time!
Oh, I gotta be the cameraman!
Nice. Don't miss any kills. Oh, they're running bot! What? Hellbringer is going bot. Maybe, yeah, they're just warding first, I guess. Looks like Hellbringer is gonna be the mid hero.
Yeah, Hellbringer will be mid. Wretched Hag is going top, so we are gonna see that tri-lane that we wanted to see.
Mortar is a really interesting item build. They decided to rush the Ring of Teacher as a support.
Huh.
Zero stats at the moment. Well, he still has 550 HP though, so yeah. Really tank intelligence here.
Wonderful run into each other into a fight.
Yeah. Legion is also running into the woods with four arrows. We might see a clash here.
That'll be awesome. Obviously the advantage is going to the Hellborn team.
Yeah. And Rhapsody actually has one of the wards.
Ooh, they're gonna be baiting the Martyr here. Martyr's going a separate way. Hopefully they collapse on it. This could be the fight. Are they going to go? Come on, bait. He probably shouldn't have thrown the hatchet at that tree. Gave it away.
Yeah, but as I said, Legion kind of anticipated them running up, so Rhapsody has a ward to place on their side of the map, and they're probably going to leave Prisoner down there and then Malk in it.
Yeah.
That would be the best decision, but doesn't look like they're going to do that.
Yep. Alright, one thing to note is that Malakin is going into this tri-lane without a shield. So all he has going to have is a hatchet against two ranged Martyr and Impath are probably going to harass him down fairly quickly.
Yep, and he also doesn't have any pooled regen.
Yeah.
Looks like they're just going to suicide the Malakin. This to me is kind of a weird decision because Malakin is kind of an early game carry.
Yeah, they're going
to
need
to snowball.
They're definitely going to need him to get some farm, but instead they're going to put the focus on the Prisoner, hopefully get some early kills on the Hellbringer. If they do land a hook on Hellbringer, it's probably going to be a kill.
Yeah, Hellbringer is awful here to play against Prisoner. Yeah. So you're guaranteed to die whenever you get caught, and Rhapsody can just set up the hook with this staccato stun.
Yeah. Alright, and then the top matchup, we got Wretched Hag versus Bubbles. And then Wretched Hag wins that lineup, right?
No,
it's close.
It's a very even matchup. But Hag has the short lane advantage.
Yeah.
Did Bubbles have any pooled regen? No, it
Bubbles
didn't.
Does not have any pooled regen, no.
I think that's a very even matchup.
Yeah. So here's a question for you. So in that matchup, Bubbles versus Wretched Hag, if Bubbles gets take cover, Bubbles should lose, correct?
It depends on Hag's skill, though.
Right. I mean, if they're the same skill level, basically, for a Bubbles to actually have the advantage into the lane, he needs to put his points into Q and W.
Yeah, but then again, if Hag goes home, he's fucked.
Yeah, fair enough. All right, so in the mid lane, things are going very, very well for this Hellbringer so far.
Yeah, they actually sent Rhapsody bot after a while.
Yeah. So, Malakin still does not have his shield. He only has one CS right now, and exactly what's happening. I mean, Martyr and Impath are just absolutely boxing him out of the lane, and then Bramble's going to be able to get that free farm.
It looks they like, have perfect lane control as well.
Yeah, and they have very good wards as well. They'll be able to see a Tempest coming. Tempest can only really work with three camps right now.
Yeah, and he's not having the best time in the jungle either.
Yeah.
I'm not sure why they sent Rhapsody down here. Like, they saw them man up with the tri-lane, and then they decided to send Rhapsody mid just to have her swap lanes again. Should have just made the decision straight away and stuck with it.
Yeah. If Prisoner gets with solid HP, gets a hook on Hellbringer. Hellbringer still should be dead, though.
Not one versus one.
But, I mean, Hellbringer's doing a very good job at boxing the Prisoner out.
Yeah.
That Death Boil is a very, very strong skill.
Yeah, Hellbringer also has quite high base damage. It's good here to last it with good attack animation. That's one versus one Prisoner is gonna get crushed in the lane.
Yes. Malakin is a decent hero to go against a tri-lane though. At least he has the escape mechanism going for him. Although I don't know.
Yeah, but rank one it's really short.
Yeah.
And it's not really what you want to use this ward.
They have the ward pulled. Rhapsody did get a Ward of Revelation. I don't think it sees it.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't see that one or the other one, so that's pretty grim for them. They're going to be trying to figure it out, but they're just not going to find it. That is very unfortunate for them, while Bramble just continues to get his farm on. And then at the top lane right now, we have Hag, who is 15-3, versus a Bubbles, who is 9-0. So Hag is doing very well in this lane. It looks like almost all the lanes are actually going right now in the Hellborn's advantage. And then the jungle isn't even doing that well. So they really need to change something up or figure something out to kind of change this around.
There's not really that much they could do, though. I mean, Rhapsody could try to gank the Hag, but I don't know.
Yeah.
They put themselves in a really sticky situation here.
And then Rhapsody would have to travel all the way top. I mean, Rhapsody isn't even doing that well because she did buy that counter ward and didn't have any luck getting the extra 50 gold back from killing the ward. Alright, so Malakin's still at 1 CS. Only CS he has is when he landed a CS with his hatchet. So hopefully he'll be able to kind of pick that around. If you were on the Legion team right now, what would you do? What changes would you make?
I would probably send Rhapsody back mid, try to just shut down the Hellbringer a bit.
And maybe get some get Pyro Prisoner a little bit steamroll, get him some energy so he gets the opportunity to gank. Alright, they're going. They got a wall. Unfortunately, it's going to miss.
And yeah, Malakin has sort of throw red anyway, but like in the position the Legion team is in right now, they're not going to be able to fight the Hellborn team for quite some time. They're just going to have to split push until they have at least a BKB on Malakin, and that's like, at this pace, it's going to be at like the 35-minute mark.
Yeah. So Bramble's going on the Impath right here. He got him with the stun. The wall is going to miss. Tempest is going to come in. They are going to pick up the kill on Rhapsody in First Blood, but are they going to get a turnaround kill? There we go. Impath goes down with Malakin picking up the kill. There we go. You got the Spit Breath coming out. Malakin's going to go down. Bramble is going to pick up the other kill. So that's 2-for-1 exchange. Somebody's TPing in. It's Rhapsody. I think the fight's going to kind of end there. Overall advantage is going to go to Hellborn with Bramble and Martyr both picking up a kill. At least Malakin was able to pick up a kill on the impasse. That went a little bit better than expected.
Yeah. Looks like the Hellborn team has been letting Bramble get most of the experience down here.
Yeah.
I haven't really been watching them, but he's level 5 already.
He's level 5. I think the others are usually spending their energy trying to box it out. Impasse has picked up another ward, and he just warded the pole again. So that's got to be pretty frustrating for the opposing team. He's going back up. Is he going to try to ward this one too? We'll find out.
The action in bot lane.
Yep, they're going to go right there. Another wall missed by the Impath, but it doesn't matter. They're still going to be able to take that Rhapsody down. Bramble's going to pick up the kill, giving him 415 gold per minute before the 6-minute mark. This is not looking good here for the Legion team.
Prisoner getting a deed rune both. Hellbringer's hasting after him.
Oh, there we go. All right. Don't think they're going to be able to do anything. Is he going to go for it? He drops his ultimate right there. Malphus is coming out.
He has a lot of damage.
He's going to go for it. Is he going to be able to take down the prisoner?
Oh,
prisoner's got some
micro
bottle charges.
Oh, they missed micro. Can they click it?
He's got the haste, though. He's wrapping around. There we go. One more hit, and he's got it.
He should be able to get mid tower with this Malphus.
Yeah. Oh, and we got more action going on. Martyr and Impath getting caught right here by Rhapsody. Malakin, are they going to be able to get it? We got the lifelink coming out, the wall going, and I think the other team is going to... This is coming in, though. Does he have a stun ready? He does, but it's only level 2, so it'll only get that one proc. Bramble is coming down. If he gets this Rhapsody, Rhapsody is going to fall. But it looks like they're
going to... Tempest finally has his monitoring.
Okay, there we go.
Make stuff happen.
One thing to bring attention to is, back on the attention in the top lane, Bubbles is actually winning the lane now. So Bubbles is going to have a CS of 31, while Wretched Hag has a CS of 31.
How did that happen? I get more than twice his last time I checked.
Yeah. I don't know. Bubbles doesn't have a lot of mana, so he's probably using a Shell Surf to pick up some good CS. He's just picked up his Steam Boots, which is great, while Wretched Hag picked up her Grave Locket. Back at the base, Hellbringer's also picked up his Grave Locket. He should be TPing back mid here pretty shortly. He was able to get the tower to about half HP with that Malphus.
Yeah.
Bramble is 6,
so... Prisoner can't really lane against him anymore, so Hellbringer should just keep putting pressure on the tower.
Looking like they want to make some action happen again. Prisoner just picked up an Illusion Rune. He will be sending one mid and one... He's going to be going bottom. Unfortunately, they do have a ward there, so they're able to see what's going on. Hellbringer.
Prisoner still doesn't have boots, though. It's like, roaming without boots is really inefficient.
Yeah, just he's going to be sending in as an illusion first. I think they know pretty quickly that it's an illusion. Malkin's coming back down. It's at his tower, so he's able to get a couple CS, which is good.
Looks like Bramble's going for Insanitarius. It's going like the hard carry build there.
There we go. That'll be fun to see. Alright, so it looks like Prisoner's going to give up. He doesn't see the gank happening, except
oh,
here we go.
Martyr.
We got Martyr. We got Tempest here. Tempest has his ultimate. We got the hook is going to miss. Tempest is coming in, though, and Tempest does have an ultimate. There's four heroes here.
They have Vision of Tempest,
bottom.
Though, with the board. They know exactly what's going on down there.
Is he going to be able to throw his Shackled out there? The old Ball and Shane. We see two right there. If they were just... Here we go. All right, so they put it on Bramble.
It's going to be a Bramble ultimate
there. We got four people bottom. Hellbringer is here. Prisoner does not have boots, so Bramble is going to be able to catch him. Hellbringer throws down Amalphis. They're going to put the attention on this Tempest, hopefully, before he can get this ultimate off. A good old Ball and Shane there. Is he going to get a good ultimate off right there? There we... Oh, Martyr kills him before he can get it off. That was just a great Ball and Shane by Prisoner. Unfortunately, it doesn't matter. Everybody comes in. We're going to see four kills now. Bubbles comes in. He's going to go. He's going to Shell Surf. Go in. He's going to get the kill onto Hellbringer. Is he going to be able to make it out? Ooh. Bramble got stunned by the ultimate. Martyr's
they
looking
can just
weak.
Dive in with Malphus since he's out of the mana.
Are they going to? It looks like they're sending Malphus in, but they're kind of trying to push out the lane.
Yeah, they got him.
Martyr's coming in. Martyr's going to hit him with a big nuke. Should kill him. Take cover. Martyr, use your spells. There we go. So, but unfortunately, Martyr's going to fall. Tempest TP's in and gets him with a stun. And it looks like the rest of the team is going to fall back while the middle tower dies in favor of the Hellborn.
That's kind of a sloppy execution on the Bubbles kill there. Pretty sure to just
Martyr
use their
just,
boost,
yeah,
they wouldn't have gotten away.
Immediately. I mean, that was a really good Ball and Chain and then a the prison break by...
It's kind of lucky that Bubbles didn't show up until as late as it did, because if he was there earlier, they could have probably won that fight pretty handily.
Tempest also did cast his ultimate, but he got killed in about right as he casted it. Martyr hit him with his retribution and just destroyed him. But, I mean, it does go to show that if the Legion team is able to line up all their ultimates, they could have the potential to really turn a fight around.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd say they still have a small window to take team fights, but when the Hellborn team gets some more items to tank up with, it's going to be real difficult for them.
If they get the opportunity to get those items.
Yeah.
They've been putting on some really good pressure. Hellbringer's back in middle lane with the tower down. Prisoner's just going to have a really hard time dealing with it. Actually, they're going to go here on... We got it. Okay, the elementals are coming out. The stuns are going. He used the ultimate. Prisoner. Come on, Prisoner. There we go. Just attack him. There we go. All right, so Hellbringer goes down. I was wondering why he didn't use his old Ball and Chain a little bit sooner, because he initiated the fight with his Prison Bake while the Tempest came in, but he didn't really use his spell to try to get the killing below. Regardless, it works out. Hellbringer goes down, a kill in favor of the Legion team, one that they definitely needed.
Yeah, that's a huge kill. Hellbringer was kind of getting out of control. It's good to get to shut him down for a while.
Yeah. So Tempest is doing okay. He's got 225 gold per minute, got his boots and arcane ring. Bubbles, on the other hand, is still doing very well. Has his ring of the teacher, bottle, and steam boots, sitting at 250 GPM. He's the highest GPM right now on the Legion team. We got four people grouping at bottom. Hellbringer's coming down here. Hellbringer does have...
Yeah, they need to get out of here ASAP, Malkin and Rhapsody. Otherwise, they're going to get...
They're getting collapsed on. Are we going to see a sword throw? No, they're just going to go on Rhapsody right now. Take Rhapsody
out.
Oh, not
Malakin.
Malakin is probably going to be fine. We're probably going to see two tower kills here from the Hellborn team, though.
Yeah.
We got Malphus.
Kind of surprised no one on the Hellborn team is going for Astrolabe. I think it would really benefit their lineup and the strategy they're trying to play right now.
Yeah.
If the Legion team gets one before them, they might even be able to take team fights.
It looks like Martyr's building towards it, because Martyr does have that Trinket of Restoration, and she has a Ring of the Teacher. I don't see her building Vladimir's.
But she also has a... I mean, it could be Vlad's.
It could be Vlad's.
Maybe they're setting up for a Roshan, Kongor, I mean.
Yeah. One thing to note is that Bubbles did get the top tower down for the Legion team, so that's some global gold
that
the team definitely
Prisoner was up there helping it.
Malakin does have steam boots now. Prisoner was able to pick up his boots and a Mystic Vestments. Mystic Vestments is going to be very, very important here for the Legion team. Almost all of the damage coming out on the Hellborn team is going to be magical.
Yeah.
Legion
I
team.
I think they would really benefit from a Tablet of Command as well.
Yes.
Get people away from Bramble.
Definitely. Looks like the Hellborn team is coming in. They do not have awards. They didn't know that they were all up here taking the Ancients. This could be a team fight coming out right now. We do have an Elemental Void out. They are going to be collapsing here on Hellbringer. We got Malphus coming out. We got the Bramble ultimate. Malakin's going to go down before he can even ultimate. Tempest is going down before he could ultimate. And then they're going to go on Prisoner 945, and that is going to be a 4-for-nothing exchange.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's the power of their lineup. They just have way better early game team fighting.
Yeah.
They also got the jump there. The rocket dropped on three people, and they just melted to the Bramble ultimate.
Yeah, that was just insane. They're going to be able to take this tower pretty easily. Bramble did pick up the Insanitarius like you said he would. They're going to be focusing their attention on this tower. And
might die to Bubbles here.
Back afterwards. Bubbles does throw his ultimate out. Malakin is going
to
TP in.
Really wanted to go
Bubbles
in.
Got the deny as well. He's going to go in, hopefully get a kill on this Empath. Empath jumps inside Hellbringer to try to get away. Malakin misses his sword throw, but is still going to try to go on this Martyr. I don't see anything coming from this, and it looks like everybody.
They missed both the sword throw and the shell surf.
Yeah.
Otherwise, they might have been able to get one kill, but in the end, it probably wouldn't matter, I think.
Yeah.
This game looks really grim for the Legion side.
Yes, yes.
But on the other hand, the Hellborn team actually doesn't have that much of, like, catching potential.
Yeah.
So the Legion team can start split pushing. They might be able to get something done.
Yeah, I really,
really
like
need
this.
To stall this game, though.
I really like this this Hellborn lineup. It's fun. Fun to watch.
Yeah.
All right, and then we got some good warding out coming out from the Hellborn team. They have the jungle warded. They're always going to know where they are. The Legion team, they brought four heroes to just kind of deal with a single stack of Ancients, which kind of just shows how far behind they really are in this game.
Super inefficient.
Bubbles is coming up. Bubbles does now out-level the Wretched Hag. Richard Hag actually hasn't really been doing much this game. He's only been involved in 3 kills, but still only has 300 gold per minute. All right, we got action. We got an Invis Bramble that's going to be collapsing here. We got an Empath Wall that was good. Lifelink coming out. Prisoner's going to go down very quickly. They're going to switch their attention to the Tempest. Tempest looks like he's going to be able to make it away after he threw his Glacial Blast down on the Bramble, who just picked up an Ice Brand. Do you think he's going to go full Frostwolf, or are we going to see a Dawnbringer?
I have no idea.
Looks like they're going to be collapsing. Bubbles did use his Cell Surf to farm, which means that he has no escape mechanism. They're going to be collapsing on him right here. He can TP. Will Hellbringer drop his Malphus? Doesn't matter because it's not up.
Yeah, but this is exactly what the Legion team needs to do. They just need to farm every single lane all the time, because as the Hellborn team's strategy is to just punch up his 5 and pop train.
Yeah.
Even if they let a hero die every now and then, they can still outfarm the Hellborn team.
Yeah, so Martyr did pick up the Fortified Bracelet and the Refreshing Ornament, so he is going to be getting that mechanism.
That's a perfect item choice.
And they're going to be pushing top here. Probably try to get 2 towers down. Bramble Ultimate should be up by the time they even get to the next tower.
Yeah.
Meantime, though, bottom lane, we have Malakin using a Storm Throw to clear these creeps. I think they're going to try to take this tower. And then if the Legion team is able to take mid and bottom tower, this will be a good exchange for them.
Yeah. And the Legion team should expect the Hellborn team to defend their tier 2 towers, so they should send someone top now ready to get that experience coming in, because there's going to be a huge wave coming in.
Yeah, I think the Hellborn team, they're going to stay. I think they're going to keep pushing. They have both Malphus and Bramble's ultimate up.
I think this is a really awkward timing, because Martyr has the money to buy a mechanism.
There we go.
He hasn't yet.
He just threw it down. Bramble hit level 11 and just threw the Entangling Vine Wall down. This tower is half HP already. Bramble's going to back. Is the team going to stay, or are they going to keep... Yep, they're going to keep going for it. They know they have an advantage. And it looks like everybody's going to walk away, and you know the Hellborn team's probably okay with that. Got the tower down to about 40% HP. Only had to use one ultimate for it, gained 2 towers. But at the same time, you said that all the Legion needed was to delay and to take 2 towers, and that's exactly what they did. We have Tempest, who's almost at 300 GPM. He got his portal.
They sent all 5 heroes up there. I think Bubbles would have been enough to just hold them off with a Shell Surf.
Tempest did pick up his portal key. He decided to go Striders into Portal Key. So they do have that with watching that last play, it didn't seem as if the Legion team or the Hellborn team knows that he has that portal key. And so basically when they were pushing, they were all grouped up. There's a high chance that this Tempest will be able to get a 5-man portal key. It's just whether or not they have the team fight and the levels and the damage to be able to deal with it. Bubbles just picked up his portal key as well. So they have two initiating heroes. Malakin's well on his way to get that Shrunken Head. He already has his Ogre Staff. Couple more solid pickups, and the Legion team could be back into it. We got a good pickup here on the Impath, both of them using their portal keys, and yep, just like that, they got a kill. Impath was trying to ward, but got caught instead. Martyr is here in Viz. There are no counter wards on any of the heroes, so he should be fine.
I don't think Malakin should be going for a Shrunken Head in a situation like this.
Yeah, what would you recommend instead?
I'd like him to go for damage, maybe a Shield Breaker or something like that, because in this situation, in order to win this game, they're going to need a huge Tempest Soul anyway.
Yeah.
And if that happens, he should just be dealing damage. Shrunken wouldn't do that much for him.
Here's a question for you. How would you like to see Prisoner getting a Barrier Idol this game?
That's a lot of money, though.
It is a lot of money, but what else would he get that would help more? Because I'm kind of looking at this Hellborn team. We got Hellbringer, magic damage, Wretched Hag, magic damage, Brambles, mostly magic damage, and then Martyr and Impath are going to be magic damage.
Yeah, it's a really good item against them, but it's also very expensive.
Yeah.
I think they would benefit more from Tablet of Command.
Okay.
But then again, Bubbles could pick that up, and he could get buried then, but someone on their team needs to get it.
We should have a team fight going on right now. If they should go on this. With Wretched Hag top, picking a fight right now would be a good idea. Bramble is tanky. He does have a Soul's Bulwark, as well as that Martyr buff. He is going to engage right here. Impath's going to go inside. They're going to engage on the Malakin, who has already used Sword Throw. Malakin's going to go down quickly. Old Ball and Chain brings in Hellbringer. Tempest lands a big ultimate, but do they have enough damage? We're about to find out. Ooh, that was good. Okay, so we got Hellbringer going down. They're going to build out, take out Bramble. Wretched Hag blinks in, gets a gold ultimate off, and really kind of cleans it up. And it looks like the fight is going to go in the Hellborn's favor. Malphus? Malphus is going to take down Matt as well as Rhapsody. Rhapsody is going to go down as well. So that is going to be a complete genocide there for the Hellborn team. Even with the 5-man ultimate, it didn't matter. Malakin got caught a little bit too soon, used a sword throw, and didn't have to use it as an escape. So while it was a beautiful ultimate by Tempest, even with all the other heroes, they just couldn't do enough damage to burst them down. Should be an easy Rax right here for the Hellborn team.
That was like the best case scenario for the Legion team, and they still weren't able to win a team fight.
Yeah.
It's really difficult to play like the just stay away game and just avoid team fights for as long as you can, but
ooh, what a great Incinitarius by Bramble right there. Is he going to go back in? They're going to try to pick up the kill on him. Malakin did go into ultimate form. He's going to sword throw in. He got two, and the slow has been affected. They should be able to pick up two kills right here. Bramble's going to come back in, and Incinitarius active. He has his ultimate up. He picks up one kill. He's going to go down because of the bubbles. They're going to switch. Empath is going to go down. All that's left is the Martyr, and the Martyr is going to go down, and the Tempest is going to live. Also, one thing to note, Rax is still up. So, very big, they had to use two buybacks, though, from Tempest and Malakin.
Oh, they did?
Yeah. But that's still, I mean, that's what they needed. They needed to get a couple kills. This Bubbles is playing very well. He's making a lot of big plays. He's being where he needs to be. He won his lane. Hopefully that's enough to bring them back into this game. Unfortunately, Malakin just picked up his Warhammer, so he's about 13 short from getting his Shrunken Head. And then nobody else really has any items on the horizon. Bubbles and Prisoner are sitting with about 2,000 each. But what do you think items are going to be coming out from them? If you were Bubbles...
Bubbles should get Tablet of Command.
Tablet of Command, yeah. What about the Prisoner?
The way I would prefer them to play would just be split pushing and maybe just get a portal key then.
Okay.
Be able to stay away from ganks. But the way they are playing, where they just keep taking team fights, I think you should get like Astrolabe right now.
Okay. So even those mid strength heroes can pick up an Astrolabe.
Yeah, well, it's a incredibly good item. in effective health on your team in total.
Yeah.
And if they keep taking team fights like this, they should have one. And you can't really expect Rhapsody to get one, and Tempest has gone for the poorly key build, even though he's up against the Hellbringer.
So Hellbringer has finished both his Barbed Armor and Sacrificial Stone, so they are just really dedicating themselves for this to this full push lineup. Bramble did get his work left, so he's going to be going into the Demonic Breastplate.
Yeah.
He just kind of built the Ice Brand to just kind of be by himself, by itself. What do you think about that?
I think the item is completely garbage.
Completely garbage by itself?
Yeah. It's 10 strength and 16 damage.
So, here's a question. Here's a question for you. How come Ice Brand is considered, as you put it, completely garbage, but at the same time, agility characters building up that Firebrand and just having a Firebrand is considered good? Is it the attack speed?
Yeah, it enhances your form.
Like, and just the agility overall, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so the Hellborn team triple stacks, takes it, going to play a little
bit slow. The
movement
speed is also huge.
Yeah. Fair enough.
But as you can see now, Bramble is at 21 armor.
Yeah.
Malekan is not going to do anything to him.
Yeah. So the martyr buff gives Guardian Angel, so it basically redirects some of the damage that they get, and it also passively reduces, and he gains experience when he dies. And then he can give people attack speed and movement speed by his aura. So this really is kind of the aura lineup pushing together. Wretched Hag picked up her Grimoires and finished it off. And it looks like Martyr is going to be creating a Barbed Armor as well. She just picked up her Ringmail, and there's already a Souls on the team, so I don't see them getting that. One thing to note is that Martyr also has the Plated Greaves. I mean, this team with the Plated Greaves, with the Sacrificial Stone, with the Souls Bulwark, they are absolutely ready to just keep pushing and keep battering this tower.
The Greaves and the Stone doesn't stack, though.
Yeah.
The Legion team is still running around as 5. I just wish you had like some heroes in the other lanes pushing them out right now.
It's hard because they've been
damage on tier 2 towers.
They've been pushing the lanes up, and so it's going to be hard to get that opportunity. And it's also probably a little bit difficult because this ward right here on the hill is about to expire, and they don't really have any offensive wards. They wouldn't be able to see him coming if they did TP back. It seems like Hellborn's pretty committed to push in this top lane, and they're going to, I think, probably stay here until they get that Rax. We do have all ultimates up on the Legion side.
Well, looks like Legion wants to get the jumper.
Yeah. So they pull in Bramble, which might not have been the best move. Empath jumps inside. He's going to get a stun off. The Empath wall is great. Prisoner is going to go down.
Doesn't have buyback either.
Yeah, nobody else even used the other spells. Bramble uses his ultimate, and they're going to go on Malekan, who does have a sword throw up, and he's going to use it to get back into the base. But then we have a Tempest ultimate, which is going to be interrupted by Malphus. Malekan's going to go down. Tempest is going to go down. Bevels is going to shell surf. He is not going to go in. He's going to stay in the fountain. We are going to see a buyback from Tempest, but he does not have his ultimate. We got 2 Malphuses up. Looks like this should be a pretty easy melee barracks. Are they going to stay and take the ranged? Yeah.
Yeah, they can probably stay and take the middle racks as well.
Yep, they're going to use the Malphus to tank, and they're going to go straight in. We have 3 heroes up. Rhapsody is still level 6, which is very grim. 0-7 with 92 GPM. Just a really rough lane for her going against that tri-lane.
Prison decided to pick up Elder Parasite, by the way. You know if he popped it when he hooked in the Bramble there?
I did not notice, no.
Just so we could die a bit faster.
So mid-Rax is going to go down. We are going to see a hook in. Great Ball and Chain right here. Pulls in both Bramble and Empath. Empath is going to go down, and Bramble's going to go down. So that's 2 quick kills. The rest of the Hellborn team is going to run away. Prisoner activates.
Prisoner activated is.
Thing
is
going to try to
catch up here.
Do they have any wards? They do have wards right here. They should be able
Hellbringer
to see this Hellbringer.
Hellbringer stopped to farm the easy camp there. He's insane.
All right, so they got a stun on him, a Glacial Blast. He's going to be silenced. He pops his Bobbed Armor. Old Ball and Chain's going to pull him and cancel the TP, which was really perfect timing. And then he's going to go down. So that's 3-for-nothing exchange right there on the second team fight. But
Prisoner is really strong when at defending his own base.
Yeah.
So he needs to stand those hooks.
But ultimately, what matters, mid-tower and mid-racks went down.
It's going to be very, very easy for the Hellborn team to get the Conqueror now as well.
Yeah.
There's literally nothing the Legion can do about it.
Malekan did just pick up his Shrunken Head, though, so for the next team fight, he will be immune to all the spells. It might be a little too late, though.
It still doesn't do any damage. The Hellborn team is so stacked on armor right now. They've got so many of the armor items. Hellborn team actually has 3 Ring of Teacher. It's kind of weird.
So it's time to get the Harkon's Blade on Malakim.
Yeah. No, but if Prisoner had bought a Bulwark instead of the Mask of Madness, and if Malakim had a Stygian, maybe they would have been able to deal some damage, but...
Yeah. Well, Prisoner does have 2,000, so he does the opportunity to buy the Soul's Bulwark now if he wanted to.
Wow, we got that money back fast.
Yeah.
He has lots of kills there.
They did get a couple bit of kills. You know, for how one-sided this game has seemed, the gold advantage isn't as bad as I thought it would. You know, 4,000 experience, 11,000 gold. It's rough, but it's not unwinnable. Two racks being down, though,
it's about the compositions as well. Like, the Hellborn team has had way stronger team fight. It's going to shift slightly towards the Legion now in the later game, but when you have that much stronger team fight and you have the gold and XP advantage, it's very hard not to win the team fights.
Yeah, it looks like Hellborn's in a skip Kongor. They don't even want it. They're just going to head straight back down bottom. Bramble did pick up a Glowstone, so he's not going to do anything. Well, he is going to turn that Ice Brand into a Frostwolf Skull. So that's pretty interesting.
He's I don't just like gonna it. Bramble has so many skills already.
Yeah, he's just going to be a tanky mofo.
That's true.
That's all he's going for. He just doesn't want to die.
I would have preferred to see like a Apostle Box or something on him, just to aid the pushing even more.
Yeah. Alright, so this tower should go down pretty quickly. Rest of the Hellborn team is meeting up with them. Malakin's going to TP back. They're going to have one final stand here at this base tower. Is Bramble just going to go in and toss his ultimate down right away, or is he going to wait?
What's the duration of it? Rank 2?
The range? Yeah.
No, the duration.
Oh, yeah. Hellbringer's standing back. Hellbringer's basically just waiting for Tempest to go in and use his ultimate so that he can interrupt it with his Malphite.
They're just letting the tower die. Like, they have to do something.
Bubbles goes in. Bubbles is actually going to be initiating. We got a good ultimate right there. Empath is going to go down. Great Rhapsody ultimate, but just out of range to be able to save the people. Bubbles went in and tried to take out the Hellbringer. Unfortunately, he couldn't do it. Hellbringer popped the barbed armor, so Malakim has to stop attacking. They're going to try to run. Bubbles is going to try to go back and make it. Doesn't matter. All the Malphire out. Hattrick coming out for the Wretched Hag, and GG well plays are called.
Yeah. I think the plan there was for Bubbles to silence the Hellbringer while Tempest used his ultimate, but...
Yeah, unfortunately
Tempest
didn't
only put 2 support, so...
Yeah, and Rhapsody had a good idea with that ultimate. She was uphill, but unfortunately she was just out of range, and the other people died. So there we go. Bunny is the loser, and we have the winners. Let's pull up the bracket really quick.
That was a really cool draft from them.
Yeah.
Well played.
That was a very good draft. It was fun to watch. So let's go to the brackets and kind of see which game that we want to cover next. So we had Team Foxy Proxy versus the Trigger Happy Bunnies. And Team Foxy Proxy is going to move on and play Sync Esports. Huh. What do you think? You think they got a chance? You know Sync loves Bramble and Martyr, too.
Oh, shit. It's going to be a weird draft, then.
That could be a pretty fun game to watch and to cast. And especially it would be fun to see how Limp... Or, I'm sorry, that's BMG. Alright, so... That's it. Congratulations to the winners. We are going to go on a little break. Next round matchup we have for you. So what do you think? Do you think we should cast Sync versus these guys?